Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Global system is under stress. There can be many factors of the stress, but I have selected four. Number one, technology. Second, climate change. Third, pandemic. Fourth, multilateralism. So how these factors are stressed in a global system? Let's start with the technology. In human history, technology always helped human to reduce the human efforts or enhance the efficiency. But it was never ever part of the decision making. But this time it is happening through artificial intelligence. So technology is becoming the competitor to human. Second, the climate change. It is introducing entirely new problems. The problem which we cannot foresee at this point of time. For example, in 2010, Pakistan was not prepared to face the worst flood of the human history, but it happened. On the pandemics, pandemics have introduced entirely two new problems, like the closures of economy and the restrictions on the mobility. In human history, we don't have any precedent where we can say that this mobility of the human was restricted, but this time it happened. On top of that, we have the multilateral system. The system which is very complex and the complicated, which making the decision making very complicated process. It also has introduced the problem of the security for the human, especially with the focus of that, the security which you cannot imagine at this time. So in this scenario, what we can do? We can do many things, but I have two suggestions. First of all, we need leadership with imagination. Leadership which can imagine what will be happen after 10 years, 20 years, or 50 years, and they can devise some policy instruments or a strategy to counter those challenges or to capitalize on the opportunity. Let's take example from the history. What leadership with imagination can make a difference after World War II? So Marshall Plan came with a vision like that. If we need sustainable peace and security in Europe, we need economic integration and people-to-people contact in Europe. And today, Europe is benefiting from the dividend of that vision. On the failure side, 9/11 report mentioned that there can be many reasons of the failures, but the biggest reason was the failure to imagine. So there can be a new threat. The government sector or the security agency, they were working with the mentality of the Cold Era, but they could not comprehend there can be new challenges. Also, that's why we need leadership with imagination. Maybe in leadership, we also need some partners like from the private sector. We have the good example already in the form of the GDL, in the form of the responsible leadership by BMW. Maybe we need some forum like now, so we can talk about leadership with imagination forum. Second part is the cooperation. One way I can question why I'm talking about the cooperation when we have the number of multilateral organization. Exactly, the number of organization is a problem which make the process very complex. So second, these organizations were built on the concept of the national state and the sovereignty of the national state. The human element is somehow missing there, are very weak. So we have to bring the human element there so decision can be made according to the situation. Lastly, I just want to say that so these are the few examples which can help us to devise a new system, which can help us to go far to combat the challenge of the future. If we fail to have a leadership with imagination and the cooperation, I'm afraid we will fail to face the challenges.